Hello and greetings from Iceland, but I just got back from a photo tour to Reykjavik where I was shooting some commercial photos and I used the tip to chase the light on the Reykjanes Peninsula, but it occurred to me to take a trip to the Vatnajökull Glacier to get close to Grímsvötn, but it's not worth it in the moment. So before I move to the latest Grímsvötn news, I'm showing you a few samples of what I've been doing, but I had a wonderful day photoshooting some of the many volcanic systems on the peninsula close by Reykjavik, and to have my own stock footage in decent quality is necessary in every sense to simplify my trips with you when I'm showing you around. And last Friday supplied me with 100 fresh gigabytes, and it would have been more if the car charger for the drone was faster or if I had more batteries, but I got what I needed though, and the videos will be online soon, one by one. Some of them will be used in news related videos when something occurs, and others will be used in my stories that cover certain regions or volcanoes. And it's still plenty of unrest on the peninsula, so I suspect that I will need that footage soon. But back to Grímsvötn. I made a short update while I was on the road, and today, Sunday, I want to move into the details with this map I just made. I just heard from scientists that it is a 50-50 chance that an eruption will occur in the coming days and weeks. The ice cap that is over the lakes that are above the Grímsvötn caldera, is now sinking faster than in the last days, in total over 3 meters. But still, there is no sign of the floodwater where we expected to come from under the part of Vatnajökull glacier that we call Skeiðarársandur, and south of that glacier we have the sandy coast called Skeiðarársandur. And now I would like to point you to a site where you can monitor the water flow in all rivers in Iceland, and you can also see the temperature and electrical conductivity, but that's one of the tools that our experts use to monitor the volcanoes that are located under glacier. And this is how you do it online, and you should be looking for the river Gígjukvísl. But note that the Gígjukvísl data was unavailable last time I checked, but hopefully online soon. So have fun with this one. But as for today, I'm a bit surprised that we have still no news, but we were told 3 days ago that we should expect to see some floodwater coming down by the weekend, but nothing yet. And you can see on a map where the water will most likely come down, or from under Skeiðarársjökull and down to the sandy beach below, Skeiðarársandur. And that is where we have the longest bridge in Iceland, built in 1974, and it was by then the foundation of the Ring Road as you know it today, the Ring Road around Iceland. But before that, those sands were a huge obstacle and it was impossible to drive the Ring Road. It simply wasn't there. And above this bridge that is 880 meters long, we have the largest glacier in Europe, and behind the glacier there are only the rural highlands of Iceland. And below the bridge we have just the ever-changing sands and of course the Atlantic Ocean. So you see how important link this was in the transport chain around Iceland. And to cross those sands was no easy task due to how wide and ever-changing the river Skeiðará was. That would however change. It was then in 1996 when an eruption occurred under Vatnajökull following an large earthquake in the Bárðarbunga caldera, Iceland's hotspot, and the magma was probably a part of the Grímsvötn volcanic system, although not all the scientists are of this opinion. The meltwater from that eruption drained into subglacial channels, and it would accumulate by the Grímsvötn lakes. And 5 weeks after the eruption started, this is what you got, or this huge flood that swept away a part of this large Skeiðará bridge, and the bridge over Gígjukvísl was swept away completely. It was then in 2009 when the river Skeiðará merged with Gígjukvísl, explaining why this huge bridge stands now there on the sands, doing nothing. And the new Gígjukvísl bridge was designed to withstand large floods, and we hope that it is up for the task that awaits her in the coming days. And we are not expecting anything like in 1996. That flood was double dose, since the eruption in Gjálp filled up the Grimsvötn lakes, who came flowing down with the meltwater from the eruption as well. But there is nothing of that kind going on now. We are just expecting the regular Grimsvötn glacier flood now. We do, however, know that the landscape under the glacier is always changing, and we know that the amount of water in the Grímsvötn lakes has never been more than now. So we have the question if the landscape under the glacier will work with us or against us, as the water is now on its way to the sandy beach Skeiðarársandur. But the biggest question remains, or will there be an eruption this time, and if so, how large will it be? And if Grímsvötn erupts, what about us, who like to observe Mother Nature doing its job? The Geldingadalur eruption was easy to observe through YouTube and other channels, but when it comes to Grímsvötn, it's gonna be just as hard as Geldingadalur was easy. Travelers have already been warned and asked to stay away from the glacier, but the Grímsvötn caldera rises 1700 meters above sea level, and it is winter. So the only way to go up there is on a snowmobile, super jeep or helicopter. But since the water is already flowing under there, it will be dangerous to move over the glacier due to cracks that will open up during the next days. So the only way to get something on film is by air. And this area is out of reach for all regular drones. So my guess is that a charter flight will be offered, but only after it's been considered safe to move around there. And that could take some days, and an eruption up there might just as well go on for only a few days. So this will be a problem for those of us holding cameras. But I am, however, pulling some strings in order to get a private pilot to get me up there, since a charter flight might not do anything for me. I might not even be able to take my long zoom lens with me, or to have the window view that I would prefer to do some serious photo shooting. So as for photography, this is the worst place in Iceland. And we can also see it through the little selection that we have of photos from the older eruptions under Vatnajökull. And in fact, there isn't possible to see any footage from there in a modern Full HD or 4K quality, making me even more excited to give it a try. But then, I'm just speculating, of course, and not even sure if we will see an eruption up there. But if so, it is expected that it will be rather small, because that's how Grímsvötn behave now. And we want those rather small but frequent eruptions rather than eruptions like in 1783. But looking at the statistics, we will have to wait for another 200 years for an eruption of such scale to occur again. Hopefully. But I hope this explained the situation for you. I'm linking to news in English, seismometer live view, the flood view, and my older videos about the same subject. And moving on with editing some of the footage that I just shot. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.